Hello and welcome to the episode 18 of the UNews Weekly, the series of audio video podcasts coming to you from the UN Information Office in Tashkent, certainly in collaboration with UN family in the country.
As usual, this week has witnessed many UN events held in the country, but today we'll have a unique program. We're dedicating it to the EcoWeek 2013.
And we'll tell you more about the details of the entire program and the campaign that took place all around the country with the help of our special guest. Today's show will be hosted by me, Bobur Komilov.
And Nigina Khaitama.
Welcome. Coming to you in this program.
On the 28th of May, the International Hotel in Tashkent hosted the EcoWeek 2013 opening ceremony dedicated to the celebration of World Environment Day and the 25th anniversary of the State Committee for Nature Protection.
It's a real pleasure to be here at the launch of the EcoWeek 2013.
The EU project targeted awareness raising for enhanced European Union and Central Asia partnership organized a media tour for journalists on return and reuse waters in Uzbekistan.
On the 30th of May, the representatives of mass media, UNDP and State Committee for Nature Protection visited a rural school number 39 in Andijan region constructed with consideration of energy efficiency requirements.
UNDP especially looked into energy efficient technology.
And finally, EcoWeek 2013 agenda includes a wide range of activities around Uzbekistan, which are exhibitions, research and practical conferences on sustainable development, media tours, children's ecological contest and others. Find out more in a special guest section.
The EcoWeek is becoming a good tradition in Uzbekistan. It was firstly launched in 2011.
Now, our first story. The opening ceremony of the national large-scale environmental campaign EcoWeek 2013 was attended by representatives of ministries, diplomatic corps and the officials from the UN family working in Uzbekistan. The event featured the presentation of initiatives undertaken by the UN and its national partners in order to achieve environmental sustainability in Uzbekistan. And here is a piece from the speech of the UN resident coordinator to Uzbekistan, Mr. Stefan Priesner.
It's a real pleasure to be here at the launch of the EcoWeek 2013. And I would like to upfront congratulate everybody who was involved to putting up this wonderful exhibition outside. I really think it doesn't only show the importance of environmental protection, but also the richness of activities that are going on in Uzbekistan. And as the UN resident coordinator, I'm especially happy that our cooperation is very, very strong in that very sector. Ladies and gentlemen, when the Millennium Development Goals Framework was agreed in the year 2000, MDG number 7 recognized that environmental protection is an integral part of the core of the development agenda. And according to official data, Uzbekistan has made significant progress in fulfilling the relevant nationalized MDG targets in the field of environment. And as I already said, the UN is very proud to have been a long-standing partner of the government of Uzbekistan in building national capacities to manage and protect the environment and to integrate environmental issues into the national development framework. I would like to stress this point. Between 2000, when MDG 7 was one of the 8 MDGs, and 2013, there has been a huge growth in awareness how important sustainable development is. Therefore, environment is likely to be much more prominent in the next development framework after 2015. Never before has it been clearer that natural resources are finite, that our planet is vulnerable, that biodiversity is degrading, and that climate change is obviously the ultimate challenge of the 21st century. And this is why balancing of growth with social and environmental dimensions of development is more important than ever before. With smart policies and the right investments, fast-growing economies such as Uzbekistan can protect the environment while at the same time generating decent jobs and accelerating social progress. So I want to stress that there is no contradiction between investment to environment and economic growth. We need to put both together and create win-win solutions for the environment and for economic growth. I would like to acknowledge that Uzbekistan is already a regional carbon finance leader in Europe and the CIS region. As a fossil fuel-rich country and an energy-intensive economy, Uzbekistan can take this as a double opportunity. Through wider deployment of investment in renewable energy and energy efficient solution to propel and to support green growth. Apart from further accelerating growth, I think it is likely that Uzbekistan can really become a model country in terms of some of the elements of environmental protection, including energy efficiency and renewable energy. And it is this important context that makes us from the United Nations really proud, based on the success of the EcoWeek in the last years, to again collaborate this year with the State Committee for Nature Protection. In bringing together such a wide array of partners to celebrate this EcoWeek 2013, to raise greater awareness about the issues at hand. So at the start of this very special week, before Environment Day 2013, may we jointly recommit ourselves that environmental protection can only be achieved if we think globally, because environmental issues don't have borders, but act locally as countries, as municipalities, as organizations, and as human beings. We need to multiply our efforts to promote sustainable development in Uzbekistan while conserving natural resources and ensuring a healthier environment for future generations. With these words, I would like to extend once again my warm congratulations at the occasion of the launch of the EcoWeek. Thank you very much.
Also an important part of the first day was the launch of the National Report on the State of the Environment and Natural Resources in the Republic of Uzbekistan. The opening event also featured a large exhibition showcasing the projects of the State Committee of the Republic of Uzbekistan and the United Nations, with materials presenting the work undertaken in Uzbekistan to ensure the nation's environmental sustainability. In the second half of the day, the Radisson Blue Hotel hosted a conference in recognition of the fifth anniversary of the small grants program of the Global Environment Facility in the country.
On the 39th and 30th of May, a media tour for journalists was arranged in Samarkand on the topic of reuse and recycled waters in Uzbekistan. Its participants had an opportunity to visit Zarafshan Reserve and other auto manufacturing companies to learn water supply and water treatment in Uzbekistan. The media tour invited reporters of print and electronic media operating in the capital and regions of the country. Have a look.
The EU project Increasing Environmental Awareness to Enhance the Partnership of the European Union and Central Asia held a media tour to Samarkand, which presented recycled water supplies and the reuse of water. The media tour was a very important part of EcoWeek, as journalists play an important role in raising environmental awareness. The media tour participants included correspondents from print and electronic media, both in Tashkent and various regions of Uzbekistan. A construction of a school located in Kurgantepa district, Andijan region, became a result of cooperation in a joint project of United Nations Development Programme, the Global Environment Facility and the State Committee on Architecture and Construction promoting energy efficiency in public buildings in Uzbekistan. During the installation and construction works, we applied the fundamental energy-saving technical solutions, which are widely used in the world practice of design and construction of energy-efficient buildings.
The main objective is to see our excellent cooperation with local hakimiyats in the Fergana Valley, meaning in three districts in Namangan, Andijan and Fergana districts. So I have come yesterday from Tashkent, have visited Namangan, today is Andijan and tomorrow Fergana. Well, I'm very impressed about the quality of School 39. I think it's a very successful joint venture between the government and UNDP, where UNDP especially looked into energy efficient technology. I am impressed about also the teaching staff and the pupils. They seem to be very motivated. They seem to be very happy to be in a school that is of very high quality. For us as UNDP, this school serves as a model for replication, because indeed when you come into this school from 35 degrees outside, it is a very, very comfortable temperature in here. And I think both in winter and in summer, obviously this is a very important precondition for effective teaching, that the temperature is conducive.
Within the framework of EcoWeek 2013, there were held many other events.
And today joining us live in the studio is, right in the run-up to the closing ceremony of the EcoWeek 2013, is Roza Iskhakova of UNDP's Environment and Energy Unit.
Welcome to the special guest section.
Dear Roza, thank you one more time for joining us today. And my first question is to do with the EcoWeek. And this year it was the third time when Uzbekistan hosted such a grand week-long campaign, and it was aimed at raising people's awareness on the different environmental issues. And how did it go?
Hi Negina, thank you for invitation. Yes, indeed, the EcoWeek is becoming a good tradition in Uzbekistan. It was firstly launched in 2011 by United Nations in Uzbekistan and State Environment Protection Committee to be part of global celebrations of World Environment Day. As you might know, this remarkable holiday was firstly introduced in 1972 by United Nations Assembly to stimulate positive environmental actions globally and to attract political action and awareness. Due to increasing understanding of close linkage of environmental issues with social and economic aspects, this holiday is being considered as very much important for sustainable development as a whole. And each year a new topic is announced for World Environment Day celebrations. This year it was Think It Safe and was focused on reduction of food waste. For Uzbekistan, the problem of waste management in general is quite topical as well and requires attention of a wide public. So the EcoWeek is a part of Global Environment Initiative. It's a week-long marathon of green events in regions of Uzbekistan, leading to a culmination on 5th of June on the World Environment Day. And from year to year, more and more partners are joining our initiative, more and more people, local communities are involved to make their contribution.
The opening ceremony took place in Tashkent, where very strong messages were raised, and for example by the UN Resident Coordinator Stefan, Priesner. And then we also had many other national partners who shared their vision of what does it matter to celebrate this global important day.
Opening ceremony is probably one of the most important events of the EcoWeek, as it is setting a strategic tone to the whole week. It is the starting point where all EcoWeek activities are announced, and after which the EcoWeek goes regional. At the opening, we try to have as much as possible people on board on the higher levels and try to include all sectors of society, including government, including businesses, industries, mass media, youth, and others. The opening is a platform where we try to attract people to participate in further EcoWeek activities.
I think that one of the most interesting parts of the opening ceremony was the exhibition which was held at the entrance of the hall, and it became very popular among public.
As a tradition, we start the opening ceremony through the Eco exhibition. The opening this year featured a wide range of projects, starting from water management and biodiversity conservation up to disaster risk management, climate change, green economy projects. The Eco exhibition is the place where everybody can come and see and find something practical for him, starting from environmental technologies that can be applied at home, for example, energy efficiency tips, how to save money and energy at home, how to water your garden and get more yields, how to survive in natural disasters, and up to important strategic achievements of the country.
As we know, this year EcoWeek expanded and had a larger scale. Could you please tell us a little bit more about the regional program?
It's always good to involve local communities in solving their own problems. So we are trying to go as much as possible into regions and involve local communities into EcoWeek activities. This year we had various events in Samarkand, in Karshi, in Navai, in Andijan and other remote areas. It was a media tour to Navai Free Economic Zone, where people could get acquainted with biogas production technology. So the people were taught how to make energy from livestock and poultry wastes. As you might know, our government highly stimulates development of renewable energy sources in the country, so this event was of a strategic importance for our country. Another big regional event took place in Karshi. It started with a cleaning campaign at the territories of Irum Water Channel and brought together 250 people. And resulted in collection and disposal of about 1 ton of waste. After that, we moved to educational institutions of Karshi city and the Kashkadarya region. Here at the Karshi Institute, for example, we had the official opening of Information and Resources Center to spread environmental knowledge among students of Karshi region. Also, in institutes and schools, we have a lot of thematic contests, which also involve many young generation and stimulates their involvement and participation in solving environmental problems. One of the contests was of regional scale, and winners of this contest will go to the final regional tour, which will be held in Almaty right after the EcoWeek. In conclusion, I would like to quote the words of our UN Secretary General, Mr. Ban Ki-moon. Words. Also, individual decisions may seem small in face of global threats and trends. When billions of people join forces in common purpose, we can make a tremendous difference. This is probably one of the key messages that we are trying to convey through our EcoWeek. We would like to stop people thinking that somebody will resolve our problems, that individual action is count and everybody should be involved to make the change happen. And now, when the EcoWeek is coming to an end, I would like to call everybody to stay green in your day-to-day life, to economize water, to economize paper, to stop using plastic bags. Invite your family and neighbors to clean up your neighborhood territories, and etc. The possibilities are endless, actually. Just keep remembering that each individual action is count and start thinking how you can contribute to the EcoWeek 2014.
Thank you, Roza, one more time and good luck.
Liked our episode? You can find it and many other stories of the United Nations in Uzbekistan visiting www.un.uz.
And of course, don't forget to log into our Facebook account, which is www.facebook.com/uniquetashkent. On Twitter, it is Twitter sign Unique Tashkent. With this, we bring this edition of UNews Weekly to an end and wish you all the best.
Goodbye.